Hello YouTube and welcome to W's DIY. In today's episode, we'll take a look at my version of the ever-popular Smitty Sled. Don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe. Deployed, the deck is 5'2" long by 31" wide.
I think that'd be great out on the ice. Only got a 10 amp hour brute battery on this. Usually only need light for a couple of hours at a time, so this should be fine.
So just do a quick walk around and give you some details on this build. 2x3 struts, front to back, 1x3s in the center, 1¼" aluminum tubing running through them, and 1⅛" wooden dowels inside. 5/16 bolts, number 10 screws. There's a close-up of the Eagle Eye light bezels that I made. And there's the switch. Now these ladder stabilizers are pretty common, but I found them way too wide to fit between the wheel wells of the truck. So I've shortened them down. These are now 43" wide. So with the skis on them, it's about 44". Those are the auger mounts. As I said, this thing's powered by the Markham Brute 10 amp hour battery. Good buy at Cabela's for $100 on sale. Comes with the SAE plug and the charger. I put that inside an insulated box that I've made out of Reflectix and landscape cloth that I've glued on with Super 77 spray adhesive. That is stored inside this weatherproof, waterproof ammo bag. $5 on Amazon. They come with these straps and clips, which attach to these tubes underneath, so the bag is suspended. And here's a look at the hasp you saw me attach after folding out the rear section. Moving on to the light post. As you see, the lights are attached to 3/4" aluminum square tubing. These lights are $6.20 each plus tax at Princess Auto here in Winnipeg. So they've been mounted to this 7-foot extendable paint roller handle. The coil cord was donated from a 12-volt plug that goes to this switch in this PVC fitting that I turned into a switch housing. Just slips over the tube here and can be rotated or slid up and down as need be. This attachment point here is PVC fittings as well. And this just slides back and forth so the tube can move if it needs to or rotate. And that is just a chair leg foot on the bottom of the rig. So this will sit on the ground. As I said, there's wooden dowels inside those aluminum tubes. And in order to use this as an anchor point, I've used a zinc insert nut, and that has been epoxied in place inside a 3/8 hole. I believe it's 1/4 inch. And then I just put a plug in there just so it sticks out just a little bit past, so we're not cutting the fitting as we rotate it once it's tight. So moving to the other fitting, it folds down. I want to remove the turn nut. There we go. Again, PVC fittings. That is 3/4 inch by 3/4 inch. Cut it open and insert a little bit of foam just to soften it when the light post snaps in. Let's go over the skis. So here at the front, I've got the eyelet. As you can see, I bent it open so I can just slide the rope right in. It's just zinc hardware. And these feet are 3D printed out of ASA plastic. They're sunk stainless 1/4 inch screws by 1 inch long. These ones are 3/4 inch long. Here is an unmounted foot. As you can see, the nuts are embedded inside. They're pretty much bulletproof thus far. They haven't seen any extreme cold temperatures, but they seem to be holding up surprisingly well. Well, that wraps up another episode, so thanks for watching, guys. I know it was a long one. As always, likes and comments are appreciated.